We now continue with more of The Mark Milton Show with The Smash on 590 The Fan and 590thefan.com.
All right, you're listening to The Mark Milton Show with The Smash, broadcasting from the Miller Furniture Studios, presented by STLTaxLawyer.com. Smash, I don't know if you're in the market for a mortgage, but the home market has never been hotter, so it's never been more important.
I wish I was, man.
To have that pre-approval from a strong mortgage lender, and we've got one for you. Andy Newbold with First Bank can help you out. Andy works with a lot of individuals, families looking to buy their first home.
Yeah.
People looking to refinance, maybe do a cash out refinance. I worked with Andy earlier this year, I guess it was in 2020, last year, to do a refinance. It was a great process. I've worked with a lot of mortgage bankers, brokers, et cetera, and I can't speak highly enough about the experience we had with First Bank, and in particular Andy Newbold. And also, they service their own loans, so they're not a broker that goes out and, you know, sells them to the highest bidder, which ultimately leads to lower fees, lower costs for you as the borrower. If you're in the market for a home home mortgage, refinance, whatever it may be, please give First Bank a shot at your business. Andy Newbold, you can reach him at andy.newbold@fbol.com, or you can call him on a cell, 314-660-2223. You can check him out on Facebook. Again, it's Andy Newbold, First Bank Mortgage.
Take advantage of these low interest rates. Who knows how long they're going to last, but right now they're there. So take advantage of them. Andy's the guy to get you to them. I, Sir Smashington, went to, and I ain't saying what it was, but I went to one of those new apartment complexes out in Chesterfield. Thought, all right, let me see what this is. I might get me my own apartment, you know? I said, what do you want? I said, well, I want a three-bedroom. I want a guest bedroom for my kids when they come to town. Sure. That way they can visit Dad. I need an office, and I need a bedroom. Well, three bedroom, sir, that'll be $3,500.
Wow.
Are you kidding me? Cool apartments, I'll give them that, but
the rent is too damn high.
Imagine what you can get for half that as far as a nice house is concerned. That's why you call Andy.
Absolutely. Give Andy a call. And also, from a tax standpoint, because, you know, I am the STL tax lawyer.
I didn't know that. Yes, you are.
Mortgage interest is deductible if you itemize. Whereas credit card debt, consumer debt, those types of things are not. So if you're paying high interest credit cards, if you've got equity in your house, you might want to think about doing a cash out refinance. That way, at least the interest you're paying on your mortgage is tax deductible, you know, as opposed to credit cards and whatnot, which are not. So that's another consideration from a tax standpoint. In other tax news, I wanted to talk about the latest COVID relief, the American Rescue Plan, as it's called. I got news for you. It's not going to rescue America. We're in deep trouble. This is just very.
I don't think it is.
Very. I mean, I'm like an old man now, but I'm like very pessimistic about our current government, our elected officials, on the national level in particular, what we're doing. I mean, this is just nuts. $1.9 trillion. We already have $28+ trillion in debt. We're going to be over $30 trillion in debt. GDP is going to be dwarfed by our national debt. I mean, it's really crisis time, and nobody seems to be. I'm like the canary in the coal mine.
Well, the crazy part about it is,
you heard
to
that phrase
this
before,
point,
canary, in the coal
canary
mine.
In the coal mine. The crazy part about it is that to this point, we never saw anything like this money being printed and this given out like that. China was our quote unquote benefactor. So the question is two things. Will we be able to cover this debt by printing more free money, or do we have to go to China and say, hey, can you guys loan us a few trillion dollars, and then boom, they own us again?
Well, if you keep printing, obviously inflation, it has to come eventually.
Yeah. Like
the value of the dollar is going to decrease.
That's right.
To your point about the debt, I don't get it. I don't understand at what point.
I'm grateful to have $1,400 coming someday.
Well, exactly, and we'll talk about that. And we're also fortunate the interest rates are as low as they've ever been.
Yeah, right.
Because you think about servicing the debt, if interest rates go up, I mean, we're really screwed then.
Yeah.
I mean, we've had relatively low interest rates for the last, I don't know, since 9-11. I mean, it's almost been 20 years.
Yeah.
Since 9-11 is when I can think of kind of a turning point
where
we, you know, the Fed slashed interest rates. You had zero, you know, you never saw 0% cars before 9-11. And then even like in 04, I think was the first time we really saw sort of the government just giving people money. There was like the making work pay credit. Was like one of the stimulating things. And then they had the first time home buyer credit, try to get people to buy houses.
Yeah.
And that was another government handout, essentially. Yeah. But it impacted housing prices, right? So it's just the government spent money, and then it impact. You know, this stuff is all, you know, well-intentioned, I think, but does it really make a difference to the people that are truly hurting as a direct result from COVID? I don't think it does. Yeah. It's just literally just incurring more debt. And, you know, you're going to get – so if you make under under $80,000, well, it's under $75,000, you get the full $1,400 credit or stimulus payment.
Yeah.
Joint taxpayers making under $150,000, they're going to get $2,800. That's why
I've asked you not to pay me any more than you pay me.
Right, exactly. But in total, so if you got $1,200 the first round, $600 the second round, $1,400 now, I mean, it's $3,200.
Right.
And that's a significant amount of money. And then the child tax credit, which is great. I think they should, I mean, I think the child, I think you should get more benefit if you have children that you're, especially if they're younger. So what they did is they made that $3,000 per child.
I know.
And $3,600 if the child's under six and you make less than $75,000.
That's discrimination. And I'll tell you why. Because the kids ain't working. All right. But the kids need support. I get that. But I'm working and I'm working my rear end off. And I lost my work because of all this that has happened. I think it should be reversed. That the person.
The old people should get.
Get the money and then the kids.
They are getting the money.
I'm only getting $1,200. You told me some kids are going to get about $36,000.
Well, their parents are. So
same thing.
Well, right. Yeah. I mean,
so their parents are. So
they're discriminating against you as not having young children.
Yeah, I got adult children.
Yeah.
But.
So you won't get anything from that, unfortunately. But I mean,
losing argument.
$3,200 free money. Plus, like if you're a family of four making, let's say you've got four kids and you make under $150,000, I mean, you're going to be getting, you know, what is that? I can't do this. $14,400 in child tax credits? It's going to be enormous. And there's also going to be a tremendous amount of fraud, as there always is with these kinds of refundable credits.
Because
they are refundable credits. So those are two big things. And then unemployment, this was a curveball they threw out there. So midway through tax season, mind you. So we've already filed some tax returns with unemployment benefits being taxed. And now they come out and they say, oh, excuse me, the first $10,200 won't be taxed. That's something. If you've already filed,
but you've already done,
and you've got unemployment, you're reporting because normally it's taxed as ordinary income.
Yeah,
they're gonna not tax the first $10,200. How that's gonna play out? We're still waiting on IRS guidance. I'm basically holding on to any returns that have unemployment until we get this figured out.
Yeah,
because obviously, you know, if let's say you're paying 25% tax on unemployment, that could be $2,500.
Yeah.
So again, free money. People who are unemployed getting paid benefits, not paying tax. Whereas the guy who's going out and working is earning money, but he's paying tax. That doesn't seem fair. I mean, I get it. It seems counterintuitive to tax unemployment, but if you look at it from a fairness standpoint, so the guy who's getting money for doing nothing is going to end up getting more than the guy who goes out and works and makes money?
Right.
That doesn't make sense.
I know.
Another. I mean, I feel like an old man today. I feel like I'm just like listing grievances.
Mr. Grievance.
Here's another one.
That's a bit we'll do. Mr. Grievance.
Mr. Grievance. The Grievance Hour.
Yeah.
Student loan forgiveness, okay? So if you get your federal student loans forgiven through one of the many options they have, like public interest student loan forgiveness, which don't get me started on that. But if you work in the public interest, which means basically you work for a charity, a nonprofit, the government. So if I had stayed at the DOJ for 10 years, I could have gotten my – paid a minimum amount and gotten my student loans forgiven after 10 years.
Really?
So that applies to all different kinds of professions that are in the, quote, public sector. So it used to be – so let's say you owed $100,000 on your student loans and you only paid off $40,000.
Yeah.
After 10 years, that $60,000 balance plus interest accruing would be forgiven, wiped out. You owe the government nothing because the federal government also took over the entire student loan industry. Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, they took it all over. Obama, no more private student loans, essentially. It's all federal backed.
Really?
So the federal government is basically holding the bag for all these subprime student loans, which is what they are.
Yeah, right.
I mean, I bet you 70% of student loans will have no chance of being repaid.
Why would you do that to a student who you want to grow to be a leading citizen for you, go out and excel for the country?
Saddle them with debt, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, because everyone needs an education, right? It's all the
terrible.
It's terrible incentives. It makes, you know, if you look at capitalism, you know, you think, oh, let's create incentives for people. Like, it basically tells people, hey, here's a blank check. Go get whatever degree you want. We'll cover it.
Yeah.
No correlation between what you're actually studying, what you might come out making compared to what you're spending. But we're going to cover it, and then we're going to hold on to the loan. And, okay, so my point is, if that amount got forgiven previously, $60,000, that would have been canceled debt, so you pay tax on it. Like, if you have a credit
tax
card,
on canceled debt.
You're supposed to. Now, no more. For, at least for the next 4 years. Yep, the next 4 years, from 2021 to 2025, if your student loan debt gets forgiven during that window, you don't pay tax. Which actually is great for a lot of my law student friends, law school friends, because a lot of them, if they've been in the public service for 10 years, that's going to... Yeah, that's a huge... I mean, if they were anticipating paying... Like, not only are you getting a loan forgiven, which is great, you're now not going to have to pay taxes on it.
Yeah.
It's a huge windfall. And almost incalculable.
Those listening, do you hear what this guy is? He is smarter than you or me, all right? He is the St. Louis tax lawyer, STLTaxLawyer.com. This is the guy, number one, you want doing your taxes because he knows all these things. I mean, he's telling me stuff that I didn't know. And then... On top of that, the guy is a fighter for you. He is your champion. He is your advocate. He is Mark Milton, and I ain't stroking him. I ain't brown-nosing nobody.
Hey, get your hand out of here.
No, I'm really astounded that you know all this much, because that's why somebody employs a guy like you, because you are the brains that I don't have.
Well, I'm thinking about quitting working, because, I mean, it seems like this is, you know, it's not really working in my favor.
I got some tax money.
I'm not really benefiting from any of this. And then, that
sounds right. You're not.
No, and that's fine. I mean, I get I've done well, but you know what? I also employ people, and this is the Biden government mentality, big government. It's like, let's punish the doers.
Yeah.
Let's give out all these handouts. Let's rack up more debt. It's crazy.
Yeah, right.
It's not sustainable.
Yeah.
And it creates these perverse incentives. And it's like, well, why would I pay off my student loan? Why would I go find a job if I'm going to get unemployment that's not taxable, where the schmo who's working at McDonald's is getting taxed? I mean, it doesn't make any sense. Why not have more kids if I can't afford them? Yeah. I'll just get more tax credits. I mean, it's just,
you don't have to be angry with me, all right?
No, I just, it's very frustrating, because
I got an
idea. I'm concerned. It comes from a place of concern.
If you are not going to do this anymore, how's your hockey game going?
It's going well.
So there you go.
I could.
Maybe you slide off to that.
Perhaps there's a senior tour.
Your side gig.
I did take this week off. Had a little bit of a knee injury.
Actually,
so I played hockey last Monday.
Yeah.
Then I played basketball on Wednesday. So 2 out of 3 days, pretty grueling activity for my...
That's why I never understood, because I got some friends who play adult hockey.
Yeah.
It's kind of like... Well, who takes care of you if you get, like, a broken leg or something like that?
That's a concern.
Well, I have insurance for that.
Yeah.
Well, wait a minute.
My wife's not going to do it. I can tell you that much right now. these other three kids are driving us crazy. So if I get hurt, I'm on my own. I'm going to be coming up to Papa. I'm going to be pulling my RV up to Papa Smash's new apartment.
I'm trying to get a tiny house at your place, man. Well, don't blow that.
We'll get an apartment together. Because
if we get a tiny house together, we're bigger than that.
If I get hurt, it's going to be a problem. So I took off this week. Probably get back out there Monday night is the plan.
I never understood why you guys go out and get battered like that.
It's fun.
Well,
you gotta stay
fun
young.
Is fun, but then... who's going to pay your medical bill?
You know what? There's a great quote at the MAC.
That's why I play chess.
In the gym at the MAC, there's a great quote that hangs in the banners.
What's that?
It says, "We don't quit playing because we grow old. We grow old because we quit playing."
Ooh, that is exactly
Which
right,
I always
too.
See that, and
That's
I think it's
right.
true, because if you stop playing, you're going to get a little, you know.
And if you don't play, you don't win.
That's true, too.
That's what I got to do. I got to get back to playing, because it's
COVID. What do you play? Play what?
I lift weights and stuff.
Get out of here. Dumbbells? We gotta
don't
do
call
it.
Me a dumbbell. I have
We gotta get
smart.
A video of this. What kind of dumbbells? 10 pounds?
5 pounds.
15 pounds? Girls? You do it in the mirror?
The pink ones.
Do you do the tricep? That's always a tough one.
The tricep like
that
is a tough
one. I like to do the
one
where
you're
gonna go over your head.
Yeah,
like
right. Gonna, you know. Right.
I gotta see this. Where do you work out?
The House of Pain.
The House of Pain. There you go. All right.
Fantastic place.
That is a good spot.
Yep.
We got a new treadmill in our basement.
Oh, you're not working there, are you?
No, but the problem is, it's one of these Peloton. Yeah, hashtag blessed. Yeah, I don't need tax credits because I got a Peloton. Whatever. All right. Get out of here. It's 12 inches off the ground. So the problem is our ceiling's like 7 feet. So like I get on there. So what I did is I removed the removable panels. So my head goes up into the rafters.
That's awesome.
And
really?
It's not awesome because if I turn, if I have to make a sudden movement, I could really do some damage. Wow. So I haven't really used it.
Yeah.
It looks really nice.
You're breathing asbestos and everything while you're
probably.
You know, while you're out there walking.
Yeah, it's not a good. So I don't really like to work
out. Why would you buy a treadmill? What did I tell you? Was one of the first things I told
you. Morning.
Was one of the first things I told
you. I didn't have coffee either, even though I'm so fired up.
Why would you buy a treadmill that's a foot off the ground, man?
Well, that's just how it is. I mean, if you had a bigger house, maybe if I could afford one, if I get some of these tax breaks, but I don't get any tax breaks, so I can't afford a ceiling with higher clearance.
You could take advantage of nature's treadmill, your backyard.
Yeah, I don't do that.
Oh, yeah.
Run. I see people running on the street.
Yeah.
That's how you hurt your knees.
Oh, how I did hurt my knee.
To answer your question, to put a bow on this, the reason I do sports is because I enjoy that. I don't like to work out. I don't like to run.
Yeah.
So
those
playing
are good
basketball,
sports you're doing, yeah.
Hockey's not. I mean, that was just sort of a, you know, on a whim. That's pretty crazy that I'm
hockey's
doing
the
that.
Most aerobic sport of them all.
It's
other
very,
than swimming, maybe.
And it's fun. Like, yeah, it's actually your feet. It hurts when you're doing it, but it's actually not that bad on you afterwards.
Let me ask a quick question, man.
Sure.
As big as you are, do these hockey players in the adult hockey they like to just beat your ass, man, or what?
Well, there's not really there's not fighting. I mean, it's like literally it's learn to play. So people, everyone out there. Now, I did unintentionally smash this guy into the boards last week.
Yeah,
I think I mentioned that.
Unintentionally?
Well, no, because I just couldn't stop, and so I like basically there was a puck in the corner, and I went for it.
Stop.
It was either him or I don't know what the option was.
So you could do one of stops where you go and
the hockey
and the ice stop.
No, I haven't been able to do that yet.
So you
I'm getting
put
better.
Your toes together
well,
to try to
just,
stop?
I was planning to use the boards to stop me. Kind of like you see those guys do that. Then he kind of slid in front. So I took pretty good hit on
it. I got to come watch you, man.
It's a lot of fun. All right, but hey, I want to tell you guys, Rosalita's. That's where I'll be headed after hockey practice.
I love it.
Get some margaritas.
Yep.
The great Sam Page, Lord Page, has extended opening of restaurants by another hour.
That's right.
So I'm hoping this week after hockey, you'll be able to grab some margaritas, some chips and salsa. Just relax. You know, after a nice hockey practice, hopefully somebody comes up and says, hey, what'd you guys do tonight? Oh, I had a hockey practice.
Yeah.
You know, just kind of manly thing. Like, hey. And we'll be hanging out at Rosalita's, margaritas, chips and salsa. Mm-hmm. Maybe get a quesadilla. I don't know. We'll see if I'm hungry. I usually do work up quite an appetite after I eat my quesadilla. Mm-hmm. You can also visit them downtown on Washington Avenue. Where their employees surely pay the 1% earnings tax. They don't pay it out in the county. Mm-hmm. So you take your pick on where you want to go, either out west to pair or downtown. Rosalita's Tex-Mex for all your Mexican food needs. Check them out.
Rosalita'sCantina.com.
This is the Mark Milton Show with the Smash, broadcasting from the Miller Furniture Studios, presented by STLTaxLawyer.com. Remember, Smash, the choice of a lawyer is an important decision. It should not be based solely on advertisements.
I'll remember that.
We'll be right back.